just wanna leave tonight. We can go anywhere we want. Drive down to the coast, jump in the sea. Just take my hand and come with me. Sing it.
Hola. Oh, Jesus. Yes, you are correct. It is I, Jesus.
What's up, Jesus? Have you come to redeem us?
Who's us? Oh, you mean you and your multiple personalities?
No, funny guy. It's about my marriage.
Oh, no, silly boy. That ship has sailed. No going off into the sunset on horse and carriage.
Oh, I thought you were coming here to clear the wreckage.
No, 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 my good son. I'm actually here with a final message.
A final message? You're going to kill me?
Slaps me. You're a pretty dense Johnny to some degree. No, my child, I'm not here to kill you.
Oh, thanks, man. I got enough problems I'm trying to power through.
Well, that is what I am here for, to give you a little poetic review. A final chance to see with your eyes, heart, and mind a different view.
I would take any help you can offer. Any assistance on getting my mind off her.
Well, that's just it, Johnny boy. That is your repetitive behavior. You are so blessed beyond belief that I am your savior. You are special to me, so I never waver to show you infinite favor.
That's true, my guy. You ain't never tell a lie.
No, I have not. So listen closely as I speak. You are very unique, my son, but boy, oh boy, do we have some things to tweak.
Well, Jesus, have at it. I am all yours. If it helps me forget Shorty 140 with the middle name Monique, because shit is looking real bleak.
And there lies your repetitive circle of nonsense. You wrote this entire book. And what were the contents?
What do you mean? Poetic therapy from, like, my life.
Correct. You started this journey with a prayer, yet spent almost the entire time on your choices choosing a wife.
Come on, man. I spoke about other stuff.
Enough!
Hey, chill.
Chill? You want me to chill? Do you know what you have done with your free will?
I'm sure you're going to tell me. But chill, be gentle.
Enough!
Okay.
Johnny, how did this book begin?
With the prayer and me trying to write my sins?
Yes, as I listen attentively with my tiny violin. This is our final poetic discussion for good reason. I've watched you long enough go through and repeat over and over again your seasons. Now that my arrival is on the cusp of completion, I am here to save you from the demons that call themselves Legion. You have had a demon in you for quite some time. This is serious, not an anecdote for one of your therapeutic rhymes. You have had the demon of lust a part of your journey the entire time.
Lust? Nah, man, I kicked that like 16 years ago. I don't even watch porn anymore.
Silence! You have slept with four women in the last 16 years. This is true. But what did you do when you broke up this last time and apart you two grew?
I reached out to a couple of my exes.
And why did you not follow through?
Well, when I was getting yeses, I realized that's not what I want to be about at all.
After pride comes the fall.
Well, I think my ego was so bruised and my heart was so broken, I just wanted to not feel that way anymore. But the more yeses I got, the more I knew I couldn't be like I used to be before. Community dick is just not what I'm built for at all.
Exactly. But what stopped you was not you, it was your Holy Spirit. Let me explain why this was not by happenstance, but was done very deliberate.
Huh?
Give me a minute. You have had an inherent demon of lust in you since the summer of 1979. When you were 3 years old, your uncles thought it a good idea to show you porn videos on the TV. When you were 4 years old, you witnessed your father's cheating on your mother with your own eyes to see. When you were 5 years old, your older cousins made you make out with little girls freely. When you were a little older, your father gave you pornographic magazines to keep you quiet while he was getting dope sick. Let us not even discuss the molestations from older family members that happened when you went to Jersey to visit. This is all happening before you even turned into your teenage years. By the time you hit 13, what, dozens of schools in different states, you learn to conquer your fears, accept the fear of abandonment, and that, my son, is how the demon reappears.
What does that mean?
Love, Johnny. I am the embodiment of love. With me, there is no in-between. You sought love, Johnny, your entire life. What man seeks to call three different women wife? A man that is seeking love. I mean, you're not afraid of commitment, obviously, yet consistently... Notoriously.
Come on, man. They weren't all that bad.
You, Johnny, you ignorant human. I am speaking about you, yourself, and you. Ooh, you make me so mad. Your Holy Spirit gave you one more chance to beat the system and learn on your own. You were so close. You were all up in heaven like, yeah, boy, look at our boy go. He's finally full grown.
That's not fair. I mean, I didn't really want my marriage to break up. I didn't want to break up my marriage.
Oh, my goodness. This is not about the breakup of your marriage. In Sodom and Gomorrah, where you live, I might add, between marriage and divorce, divorce has a greater percentage.
Oh, I thought you came through because you found out about yet another stain on my jacket.
Oh, my. Johnny, look, you will forever make mistakes. This is about your habits. The reason for this final poetic message is because the unsharpened pencil must die.
What?
Don't cry.
I'm not crying, but why must the unsharpened pencil die?
Johnny, it's over. Sorry to tell you, you have repeated yourself enough. This is not a bluff. You made your own love life tough. Think about it. Every single encounter with me is because of either the elation or destruction of a relationship. This entire book could be called Relationships. Your relationship with women, with friends, with your daughters, with your sons, even with me. The prayer represented you at your lowest place, and you sought answers from me. I would not intercede with your free will, but I left you breadcrumbs from time to time to guide you because you always believed in me. However, you never on your own took the small key to quell your lustful thirst.
But I did quell my lustful thirst.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? You did, huh? So you followed the simple four rules of life uncoerced.
Huh?
Seek the kingdom first.
Rosie brought you to the water many times. You did not drink it. Melanie succeeded where Rosie failed because to my divinity, you finally had the wherewithal to submit.
Yeah, and then I lost everything again.
You lost nothing, Johnny. Seeking the kingdom first means praying for Jesus Christ's return and God's righteous rule, but striving to live by the laws of the kingdom of God now. This is how you achieve true Zen. It also means prioritizing love over survival. Every action you have done since you were young has been about survival. There is no blame on you for that. A lot of that was out of your hands. After this last marriage, common sense demands that the book that Melanie chaptered out for you lie your next set of plans.
But I have been reading, like, vigorously.
I know you have. Also, working out every day, eating right, you quit cigs, and alcohol is no longer a problem deliberately. You see? Look, I'm not going to go back and forth with you. We have done that enough. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah. You're right. All right. Go ahead.
Look, son, I know you're sad right now. You lost a lot this go around. But trust me, it was for the best. She was never going to love you the way your life needed her to. And to your face is exactly those words she expressed. Rosie brought you to the water. Melanie made you drink it. In between those two moments, you wrote this book, and now it's time to submit. I love you, son, more than anyone who has ever loved you or ever will. You can do one more to say goodbye. This is the season to focus and be still. I will guide your steps from here on out. It is time for you to truly feel fulfilled.
We can do anything if you put a mind to it. Take your whole life, then you put a line through it. My love is yours if you're willing to take it. Give me a heart, cause I'm gonna break it. So come away, start it today. Start a new life together in a different place. We know that love is how all these ideas came to be.